I was abused as a child, sexually, you know, exploited. So I went through a lot. Okay, I did study really well and I was a good student. I did get a marriage seat for medicine and I wanted to be a cardiologist, but my dad couldn't afford to pay the fees for me to, you know, go to med school. And so I had to drop out and, you know, do something else. So a lot of challenges, but I think that's a long story, and I have my share of trials and tribulations. So I still managed to grow, you know, get an MBA in HR and master's in English and, you know, move on, you know, with business management courses and, you know, studied and, you know, came up. I was an HR professional, worked with large corporations, and I kept growing, you know, from, what you say, you know, through the ranks. However, when I reached senior management, you know, and of course, then the glass ceiling hits you again, and you're again faced with, you know, you're the only woman in the boardroom, and your views and opinions are not considered. And I said, what am I doing with my life? You know, where am I going? So, you know, though I have overcome so many obstacles in life, I don't think I've grown as a person. And that's where, you know, my journey into understanding human behavior, you know, why people, you know, do what they do, why they behave the way they do. And I started studying psychology and human behavior. So today I stand here in front of you as a human behavioral coach. So the journey is mine, and I would like to share with you, you know, what helped me transform as a person to where I am today, where I'm working with individuals, teams and organizations and helping them, you know, understand their natural strengths and how they can, you know, discover their strengths and harness for peak potential. So what really helped me? I think it's tan. So all of us love to get a tan, you know, be by the beach and get a tan. But what the tan really means to me is, you know, the T stands for the power of thought. So the first thing that transformed me was, you know, to look at people as different and not as good or bad. Okay, so I stopped judging people. I said, this person, you know, earlier I would say this is good, this is bad. People, events, situations, I would judge them. And I just stopped judging them. I said, this is different from who I am. So when I changed thought, the power of thought, you know, there was a change in me. And the second thing was the A, which is the power of association. So, you know, like a raindrop leaves the cloud, if it falls in the Ganges is a holy river in India, it becomes holy water. And people, you know, carry you and keep them, you know, in your prayer rooms at home. But if the same raindrop had to fall on a flower, it would become a dewdrop. And if the same raindrop fell in a gutter, it would just be useless and dirty. So I said, I am a raindrop, but I choose to associate myself with people who, you know, empower me. So that was the power of association that changed me. And lastly, the N, which is the power of now, which is, you know, I just learned to be present. Just, you know, my five senses, being present, see, you know, the person who's in front of me, hear them, you know, feel them, feel their emotions, you know, what are they exactly saying? So really, you know, so just be present, you know, enjoy the present and really understand the person in front of you. So I think the tan, you know, the power of thought, the power of association, and the power of now is what transformed me as a person and as I stand here today. And that's my journey, and I hope many more people, you know, carry this forward and we build a better world for all. Thank you so much for having me here.
We've added a new word in our dictionary as tan, as a new word of inspiring people. And I totally agree with you. We should be present. If we're in our room, we need to be present. And the non-judgmental part as well, you know. Yes. We do it on an everyday basis. We see somebody and we want to have an opinion, you know. So how do we stop ourselves? So thank you for addressing that.
I just want to say that I'm writing a book on the same, and my book is called Discover Your Mojo. You know, mojo is your own unique magical charm. So I think everyone needs to figure out what your magical charm is. So tan worked for me, that was my magical charm.
Wow. Okay,
so